Hello, today I'll be doing a short presentation on emotional self-efficacy, or ESE, and more specifically, what it is, how it develops, and its effects. So what is ESE? Firstly, it's important to consider Bandura's self-efficacy theory. Self-efficacy theory considers an individual's belief in their ability to perform a behaviour. However, Bandura concludes that viewing self-efficacy generally is not beneficial, and rather individuals should view it from specific domains, and thus ESE arose. ESE considers an individual's belief that they can control their emotions within a given circumstance, whether these are positive or negative emotions. Let's take John, a 35-year-old male at a football game. If he has high ESE, he will believe in his ability to manage his anger if his football team loses and will not yell. Or alternatively, he can believe that he will contain his joy if they win to not offend the other team. So how did John's ESE develop? Literature highlights many factors that play a role in ESE development. These include age, gender, learning, and culture. Despite literature trying to deem one the most important, they are hard to separate and often go hand in hand. For example, as all individuals age, their positive ESE will increase, whereas for negative ESE, this is dependent on gender. Males believe that they can manage negative ESE better during adulthood, and this may be a reason as to why John thought he could manage his anger in the football game, whilst females believe that they can manage negative ESE better in old age. Additionally, social theories would highlight culture and learning as imperative to ESE development. Social learning theories such as operant conditioning and self-efficacy theory would state that individuals are shown to model the emotions they see and vicariously experience. This is further emphasized within social identity theory, whereby individuals would steer towards emotional expression that is aligned with in-group behaviors. This may explain why John has high ESE in his ability to manage his emotions, as this is what his culture would have modeled and taught him. Then what are the effects of ESE? Again, literature states that there are many effects that should not be viewed as independent concepts, but rather all aligned and combined to create an individual's identity, personality, and behaviour. Literature highlights performance, mental health, motivation, and well-being as all being affected by ESE. Namely, when ESE is low and individuals do not believe in their ability to manage their emotions, all these aspects are negatively influenced, including poor performance, low mental health, low motivation, and decreased well-being. Whereas when these are high, all these factors are rather positively influenced. ESE is an imperative concept to consider as it affects many aspects of everyday life. Individuals should keep ESE in mind as a factor that may explain their emotional expression and furthermore why we as individuals are motivated to perform, act, and feel in certain ways. For more information, see the Wikiversity link below.